Good morning, Holy Spirit, for such a beautiful day. Creator of heaven and earth, we thank you for your spirit guiding us to avoid fake gospel, but giving us the great joy to walk in truth and those trusting Christ to live in truth, to live in love, to live in obedience. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, great joy comes to those who help others grow in truth. The Apostle John said his joy was made complete in Christian fellowship by declaring that it has given me great joy to find some of your children walking in the truth, just as the Father commands us. 2 John 1:4. The truth is the truth of our Jesus Christ, that God loved us so that he could demonstrate his mercy to us in the person of his Son, Jesus Christ, and to us to love one another just as we heard from the beginning. 2 John 1:6. As opposed to the lies of the false teachers. 2 John 2:21 to 23. God loves us not because we have something to offer him, but rather because he had something to offer us. First John 3:16. Just like on any wedding day, the nervous groom will look through the eyes of the bridegroom and say to his new bride, "Honey, you are of extravagant value to me." In like manner, everyone around us, beloved, is of incredible value to God as a potential object of his mercy. His one and only Son died in their place because people matter so much to him. Therefore, they ought to matter to us. And we, for that reason, need to love them as God loves them. This is the basics of following Christ, truth and love, and cannot be separated. And these are vital to the Christian life. Beloved, walking in truth and living in love means that when we know somebody really believes in us, we have something to offer that person that nobody else can do and amazingly accomplish to bring the best out of that person, for God to help him or her to become successful and fruitful in the vineyard of God. We have the truth. We have love and power of the Most High God on the inside of you, to believe the best in people, to help bring the best out of them. Beloved, do you have a desire deep down inside of you to help troubled teenagers, for instance? That is what walking in truth and living in the love of Christ means. These troubled teenagers simply need somebody to spark a bit of hope, encouraging them by looking through the eyes and saying to them, "Yes, you can do it. You have got what it takes." Even your own children, are you believing the best in them? Are you instilling the confidence in them that they need? Telling them that they are going to do great things in life? Are you believing the best in your loved ones? Maybe some of them have gotten off course. Don't give up on them. Don't write them off. Make sure they know that you are concerned and that they know that you really believe in them as you give them hope within the confines of living fearlessly in a scary world. As the Bible says, the Lord takes pleasure in those who fear Him. Psalm 147:11. The reason we can walk in truth and love is in the fact that we can fear God and put our hope in Him for His blessing of the promise of provision, of the promise of protection, of the promise of prosperity, of the promise of privilege and of prolonged days. Beloved of Christ, may the good Lord revive your hope and be at rest knowing that the Lord is with you. Thanks for listening and stay blessed. Bye-bye.
All my heart to Him I give, ever to Him.